Hello, YouTube's Crosama, and here we have today from the Frame Arms Girl line is Stylet. Now, this is the AIS color version, so this is a pretty difficult one to find, just kind of like on a more retail state. But if you want, you could definitely still go to Gundam Labs and you can actually find the original Stylet, the blue version. And for a pretty reasonable price, you can go ahead and pick her up and then, you know, repaint it into this color if the more red color scheme is something that you're really looking for. And also don't forget to use the coupon code CROSAMA for that 10% off. But let's go and move on to the review. So with this Stylet, you're not going to get anything different except for the water slide decals. That would actually be a little bit different for this kit. But other than that, everything is going to be the same mold. It's going to be the same weaponry. Essentially, all you are really getting is just the recolor and the water slides. So with starting off on this review, we're going to take a look at all the details. So with taking a look at the head sculpt, it looks really, really good. So essentially it is acting as like a helmet. You can kind of see with the aesthetics of it, but I do love the top portion that's going to be on her forehead. The bottom jaw part, that little white piece, is fairly difficult to get in there. So I would recommend gluing it if possible, but overall the head sculpt is looking really good and she is going to have some nice ponytails that I pretty much prefer over the short hair or even just kind of like the more mid-length hair. So taking a look at the body, the best part is going to be that blue that's already pre-painted. So you're not gonna have to worry about putting in stickers or decals or having to paint it yourself if you're gonna just go, you know, the straight build approach. But regardless, it looks really good and it just really contrasts very well with the black as well as the red. Unfortunately, I will be repainting this, so this blue will be going away, but I'll just go ahead and paint over it with a better blue anyways. The arms are pretty nice as well with multiple different color tones. So you are going to have some of that white, you got that like very nice bright red, you got the brown and other different separating colors all inside there. And now for the waist area, you're pretty much going to have that nice little armor piece for the front of the skirt. But that skirt is just always, like for these Frame Arms girls, you're going to have either the skirt or you're going to have no skirt. And it just leaves you to wonder what is even the purpose of having the skirt in the first place. So taking a look at the legs are going to look really good with that bright red. That's kind of like the main, you know, focal point of these legs. And you're going to have that blue right up there at the, you know, more thigh section. And it's going to be pre-colored as well. So no need for painting or anything of the sort. The brown, once again, I think it looks okay with that red, but I really don't care too much for it. That's why I'm going to go ahead and just recolor it overall. Also, one thing about the feet, which I think is pretty neat, is they're pretty much going to have like these little blade, like, little wheels on them, so I'm guessing like just when she's on the ground she could definitely you know, have some better maneuverability, much like she does in the air. And also one little aspect I am just absolutely in love with are the little fins is on the legs. I think that's super cool and it makes her just look a little bit more like an actual plane. And lastly, just looking at the details on the backpack, it's a single thruster with some little fins on the side of it, which I think looks just beautiful. However, you know, I'm not really going to use this because I do have some of the MSG parts I'm going to use in its place, but I think this is something I can definitely, you know, get behind maybe in a later project, especially if I get a second Stylet. I would like to make dual thrusters out of these, but you know, regardless, I just wanted to go ahead and showcase this for you because I think it does look pretty cool, even though I am going to be replacing it. Now let's take a look at articulation. So for starters, the head is going to be on a ball joint. Pigtails are also on a ball joint. The base of the neck allows it to move back and forth. Ball joint at the shoulder, and also some mobility pretty much on the shoulder so you can have a good wide range of movement. Shoulder armor can move pretty much back and forth as long as you have the ability to rotate out of the way of all obstacles. The fin can also do a 360. One point of articulation right here at the elbow. Hands are on a ball joint. The torso is gonna be on a ball joint. Backpack can rotate back and forth. Some of the skirt pieces can also move up and down. Hip is going to be on a ball and socket, so you're going to have a decent amount of movement, but honestly this pops out more frequently than what I would like to admit. Rotation at the thigh. Two points of articulation right here at the knee. This little knee piece actually comes out and has like its own little articulation, which I don't really know what that, you know, ties into, but yeah, it's definitely there. The foot is going to be on a peg so it can move down that much and up this much, as well as the front basically moving side to side, and the wheel able to rotate outwards. Now with the hands, you are gonna get multiple pairs, starting off with the fingers extended and joined, these fists, these pointing fingers, these separated finger open hands, a and then these gripping hands made for accessories. Now moving on to facial expressions, you are going to get this more straight-eyed smirking face, right-looking smirking face, more neutral right-looking face, and lastly this screaming face. So for weapon accessories, we're going to start off with the long and the short katana, which can both be mounted on the backside. And you can also use a single carrier just for one sword. So with our two swords equipped, you can definitely pull off some pretty nice poses with her. Overall, I do actually like the swords, but because they come in that very plain kind of, it's almost like a dark grayish brown, very odd color. But regardless, you're going to have to paint the entire thing. So it's, you know, kind of on to you if you really want this to completely paint, or if you just like the way it looks as is, then that's fine as well. But yeah, it's definitely going to have to use some paint to look pretty good. So take a look at the minigun, which is going to be her main weapon. I think it looks cool. It's definitely amazing, especially with paint added to it. You can get some nice little effects, especially with a heated barrel. I think that would look pretty cool. But the problem is that it's going to be very difficult to really get it mounted on the hand. So if you're going to paint it, I'm pretty sure you have the knowledge to go ahead and just mod it a little bit. But for straight builders, I mean, hopefully you understand a little bit of how to mod it. Maybe just, if you're like me, maybe just add a little bit of glue to it and then just let it dry and try the joint again. But it's going to be very loose in the hand. Other than that, it's definitely a nice weapon, so if you want to utilize it, I definitely would recommend it. And the last weapon set you're going to have is going to be these two missiles. It pretty much connects on the underside of her forearm, but you can connect it to any other peg hole that is actually revealed on this kit. And the last accessory you're going to have is, of course, the Frame Arms Girl iconic taking the little stocking off the leg. So it's pretty cool. I mean, if you kind of like the undressing little pose, but ultimately it's something I'm not really going to go with. But yeah, if this is something you really like, it definitely is going to come in the kit. Well, that's all for the review, guys. So my final thoughts on this kit is that it's fantastic. Whether you get the red stylet or the blue stylet, they're both essentially the same kit, just gonna be different decals. But overall, I love both of them. I think the aesthetics are fantastic. The weapons is something I would recommend maybe looking to get something else from the MSG line. But if you're really just gonna stick with the default weapons, I think that's fine. However, I would probably go for something that's a little bit more dynamic, especially like the little missile pods. You know, slap those on the shoulders or something, and I think it's gonna look way, way better. Other than that though, yeah, it's a great kit. It's a little bit of the first wave of Frame Arms Girls, so I do prefer more of the later editions of this line. However, you know, the style, it's gonna be an amazing pickup no matter what. But yeah, like always, rate, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. Tell me in the comment section below if this is something you want to pick up or you already picked up, or maybe, you know, a reason why you won't pick it up. And also, go to Gundam Labs, check out their site, check out all the selections they have. And if you do decide you want to get the stylet from that site, definitely use that promo code CROSAMA so that we can get that 10% off. But anyways, guys, I definitely appreciate y'all for watching, and I'll be seeing y'all in the next video. Bye-bye.